Hello everyone and welcome to another Affinity Designer tutorial, creating a custom pattern. A three-part lesson drawing the pattern using simple shapes, working inside the expert persona with the slice tool, and apply a bitmap pattern fill on a garment. Alright, inside Affinity Designer with a new document open, first, I will go ahead and use one of the geometric shape tools. In this case, I will use the diamond shape. So I will tap on the toolbar here till I get to the diamond shape, the diamond tool. And then I'm just going to tap and drag to just create a random diamond shape. But then inside the Transform Studio, I will set its width to 400 and its height also to 400. Then I will tap on the document menu, tap to grid on the grid, and then tap to show the grid because that will help me to align things up. And then I will switch to the move tool and I'm just going to place this around the center. It doesn't really matter. What matters is that we convert this into curves. So I will tap on the edit menu and then tap to convert curves like so. And the reason I did this, because I would like to have those two corner points to have round corners. So for that, I will grab the corner tool. Just make sure that you marquee select these two nodes. And then at the bottom of the context toolbar, I'm going to set the point radius to something quite high. Let's see, I'm going to go here 120. Doesn't really matter. What matters is I'm looking at the end shape. Once you're done with this, once you're happy with your shape, don't forget to bake its corners. So we'll tap on that, and now we have a shape with curves. All right, great. So what's next? Well, first of all, let's go inside the Layer Studio, and instead of a stroke, I'm going to swipe this to the right to get to the fill color, and I'm going to set this fill color. Then looking inside the Layer Studio, here is the first curve. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to create a bunch of duplicates of that and then size them down. But for that, we're going to use actually the Contour tool. Let me show you how. First of all, let's go ahead inside the Edit menu and create the first duplicates. Grab the Contour tool and at the bottom of the context toolbar, the only thing I'm going to change is the point radius. And I'm going to do this numerically, so everything is equal as I go in. So that will be set to minus 20. Immediately after, I'm going to bake its appearance. So I will tap Bake Appearance. And then, of course, I'm going to change the color here. Tap to create another duplicate. Still with the Contour tool, tap on the point radius. I'm going to set this back to minus 20. I will bake its appearance. I will change its color. Back on the edit menu, duplicate that. Still on the Contour tool, I'm going to set this to minus 20, bake its appearance, change the color to that perhaps, create another duplicate, still with the Contour tool, set this one to minus 20, bake its appearance, change the color to this, and believe we have one more duplicate. Again, we're going to set this to minus 20. And then, of course, bake its appearance and then change its color. This is what I was going for. Okay, I like the shape. All right. So this is the shape that I was going for. And this will help us to go to the next step, which is to define the pattern using the slice tool. Now, before we jump into the expert persona, we need to define our pattern and which shapes will make that up. So first, I will marquee select all of these curves, all of these vector shapes. And inside the Layer Studio, I will go ahead and tap on the group icon to create the first group. And then I'm going to size this down to 200 by 200 to be able to control the pattern within the grid. And that will make things easier once I jumped into the expert persona using the slice tool. Now, I will also tap on the Transform Studio to double check my work. And I can see here under the dimensions, the width is slightly off. All I'm going to do is just nudge this back and forth. And now it's set to 200 by 200. Great. Now, I will make three duplicates here to define the pattern. All right. And this very next step is such an important step because everything has to line up perfectly fine, because the slightly off of one pixel will damage the pattern. So everything has to line up, and I believe everything does. And that's another reason that I used the grid here. All right, so now we are ready to jump into the export persona. So we tap on that, and here we're going to use the slice tool. So tap on that, and then I will tap and drag to create the slice here. Now I'm going to define the area that I'm going to export. I know I'm not going to do a great job. I'm just going to eyeball it. But now, okay, we need to do this accurately. So, for example, this slice switch window that we get is such an important window because that gives us all the information we need. For example, we have the dimensions, which as you can see is not correct. This should be 600 by 600. Then we have slice one. That's the default name that comes from Affinity Designer for the slice. The PNG is the file format that this slice will be exported, which of course we can change. Then we have the RGB and the 8-bit. Great. So how do we do this accurately? Well, first of all, you have to zoom in quite a lot and then just tap and drag this and that will snap into the grid. And that's why we are zooming in so much here to make sure we do a perfect job. So I'm going to go all around and I will double check everything. And now everything seems to be okay. You see that this slice switch window tells us this is 600 by 600. All right. But we're not ready yet. What I'm trying to say is if I look inside the slices studio, I can see that the pattern actually has a white background. But in this case, we want the slice to be transparent. So how do we do that? We need to tap on the document menu inside the canvas, tap on the transparent canvas, and that reflects immediately inside the slice studio on the preview thumbnail. Great. What else can we do? Well, I will go ahead and tap on the slice options here. First of all, I'll rename the slice one to perhaps retro pattern. Tap OK. Next, we have the export file formats. Mine is set to PNG. Now, Affinity Designer comes with a plethora of these export options, and I highly recommend you experiment with different file exports for your own project, depending, of course, what you're after. All right, great. So mine is set to PNG. And then we have the increased level of resolution. By default, we have the 1X, which is the standard. Then we have the Retina, and then we have the 3X. You can have all three if you wish. I'm just going to stick with the 3X, and then I will tap back on the Slice Studio. And one more thing we can do is we can tap on the prefaces here and choose an export folder of our choice. I already have done that. So all I'm going to do now is tap on the export icon, and that gets exported to the designated folder that I have set earlier. So now we are ready to go to the next step and actually use this pattern to fill the garment. All right, so we are ready to go to the next step, which is to fill this pattern we exported to the garment. So I will tap back on the Designer Studio. And before I actually do that, a couple of things I would like to change here. So I will tap back on the document menu, tap on the canvas, and then tap again on the transparent canvas, just because I like to have a solid background color. And then back on the document menu, tap on the grid and toggle off the visibility of the grid. Great. Now I will tap inside the Layer Studio and I will toggle off the visibility of all these groups. I will turn on the visibility of the first layer, this background layer, just because I like the color. And then, of course, we're going to focus inside the mannequin group here. So if I twirl this down, we can see that we have a belt, a garment, and a frame. And by the way, I am providing this vector file inside the exercise folder in the event that you would like to use that for your own project. Great. So now I will tap on the garment, tap on the edit menu, tap to duplicate this, and I will focus on that specific layer. I will fill that layer with the pattern. So for that, I will go ahead and grab the fill tool, and at the bottom of the context toolbar, we're going to cycle through the different types here. So I will tap, and I'm looking for the bitmap option, which is this one. And then I'm prompt inside the destination where I saved my own pattern. So tap on that, and here is the pattern, right? So we're going to take this center point here, which we can use it to place this bitmap all around the shape within the boundaries of the shape, of course. And then we have those fill handles here. So I'm just going to bring them inside, right? And by the way, you can rotate this, doesn't matter, whatever you want. It's quite flexible. Something along those lines. That's the one thing. The second thing is to tap on this layer here, and we're going to set a different fill color. So I'm going to tap on that and perhaps use this color. And that's why we use, for the first garment here, that's why we use we set the pattern to be transparent. So we have all the flexibility in the world that we can set this and put this pattern in any surface. All right. So everything looks great. All you have to do is perhaps take a piece of paper, sketch out your idea, use simple shapes, bring them together, and define your own pattern. Hope that helps. See you around. I would like to thank each one of you for visiting my channel, watching the inspiring lectures and project tutorials. Do not forget to subscribe and share the knowledge.